All right, time for lesson two. In this lesson, we're going to discuss what major scales are and what they're made up of. As you can see here, a scale is a series of pitches presented in a stepwise arrangement that together form a recognizable pattern. And they begin on the same letter of the musical alphabet, such as A, B, or C. A major scale is formed by the pattern seen on the screen. So, whole step, half step, whole step, whole step, whole step, half step. I'll demonstrate that now in the key of C major. So we start on C, we have a whole step to D, whole step to E, half step to F, a whole step to G, a whole step to A, a whole step to B, and finally half step to C. The same pattern can be applied to any letter name of the musical alphabet. I'll demonstrate it now on D. So we start on D. We have a whole step to E, a whole step to F sharp, a half step to G, a whole step to A, a whole step to B, a whole step to C sharp, and a half step to D. Now I could go through every major scale on all 12 notes, but I simply don't have that much time. So instead, we're going to move on to the key signatures and what key signatures have how many sharps and flats. The first table here shows the sharps in each key signature. As we can see, the key of C major has zero sharps or flats. The key of G major has one sharp, which is F. D has two, F and C. A has three, F, C, and G. E has four, F, C, G, D. B has five, F, C, G, D, A. F has six, F, C, G, D, A, E. And C sharp major has F, C, G, D, A, E, and B. You may notice that the first sharp is always F, the second is always C, third is always G, fourth is always D, fifth is always A, the sixth is always E, and the seventh is always B. Now we're going to talk about the flat key signatures. You can see that the key of C major has zero flats, F major has one flat, which is B flat. B flat major has two, B and E. E flat has three, B, E, and A. A flat has four, B, E, A, D. D flat has five, B, E, A, D, G. G flat has six, B, E, A, D, G, C. And C flat has seven, B, E, A, D, G, C, F. And you'll notice that the flats have the reverse order of the sharps. Remember that the sharps went F, C, G, D, A, E, B, and the flats go B, E, A, D, G, C, F. Now we'll talk about what a fifth is in intervals in the next chapter, but here you can see the circle of fifths, which relates the key signatures to numbers on a clock. As you go clockwise, you can see the sharp key signatures, and as you go counterclockwise, you can see the flat key signatures. You can see that the first number is C at 12 o'clock, which has zero sharps or flats. As we go clockwise, G is next with one sharp, which is F sharp, you remember. D is next with two. And on around all the way to C sharp major. And the same can be said for counterclockwise.